Now I'd like to inform you, my fellow chefs, on what's to come. There will be lighting effects, smoke, and bubble machines! And last but not least, moi, Chef Louis. Oh, that was a good one. Now, also, a friendly reminder that there is no flash photography, no recording of any kind, and please keep the aisles clear. Now, let's start the show.
The clear, wide blue here. I feel completely new here in the world above. It's like my life was wrong, and somehow now at last. seems to be somehow calling to me from this strange new world above.
Steady as she goes. Windward. Ho! Oh.
I'll tell you a tale of the bottomless blue and its hay to the starboard heave-ho. Brave sailor, beware, cause the biggins are blue in mysterious fathoms below.
Fathoms below, below, from whence sailor westerlies blow.
Where Trice and his king and his merpeople sing in mysterious fathoms below.
Isn't this perfection, Grimsby? Out here, with the seas meet the skies, surrounded by nothing but water.
Oh yes, it's simply delightful.
The salt on your skin and the wind in your hair and the waves, they gab and they flow. We're miles from the shore and guess what, I don't care.
As for me, I'm about to heave ho.
Draw the line. Sing you a song of the king of the sea and his hay to the starboard heave-ho. The ruler of all of the oceans is he in mysterious fathoms below.
King of the sea? Why, that's nautical nonsense. Nothing but a superstition.
The king of the ocean gets angry, and when he gets angry, beware. I'm telling you, lad, when King Triton is mad, how the waves all buck, rock to and fro. Hold on, good luck, as down you go.
What is that? Do you hear something?
For Lord, please, enough seafaring. You've got to get back to court, to honor your father's time wish, and take up his crown.
Suppose I don't want his crown.
You'd forsake his kingdom. All of his treasures?
Treasures? You mean like this? Who needs it? We drink straight out of the bottle, don't we, boys?
Yeah!
Or this? Not when we got the sun and moon to light our way. Or this? No thanks. I'd rather eat with my bare hands.
Yeah!
You're a prince, sire. Not a common sailor.
These men are anything but common. They're free, Grimsby, truly free. They don't have to answer to anyone but the sea. I'd rather be a sailor than a prince anything. There it is again.
We ought to head back to shore, Your Majesty.
Indeed, we should.
Not while I'm captain. Now follow that voice to the ends of the earth if we have to.
Aye, aye, captain.
There's mermaids out there in the bottomless blue, and it's hay to the starboard heave-ho. Watch out for 'em, lad, or you'll go to your ruin, mysterious fathoms
now, aren't I? With you? Flounder, you're blushing.
It's a sunburn. You get those up here.
Are you flirting with me?
Ew, gross. No way. But if I was?
Well, look what I found today. It was floating in the wake of a giant ship.
Treasure.
I'll say. Have you ever seen something so incredible in your entire life?
But what is it?
I don't know.
Airspeed, check. Altitude, check. Landing gear, check. Clear the runway. Hello, Ariel.
That I know just could ask. Scuttle, look what we found today.
More human parafunicular, eh? Well, you've asked the right bird. I'm an expert on this very speciality.
Can you tell us what it's for?
Oh, this is rare. Redonkulously rare. And in cystine condition.
What is it?
It's a dingle hopper.
A dingle hopper?
Commonly used in saloons, yes, of the beauty variety. Humans, they like to wear their hair in tails. Pony, pig, or duck, it's all the same to them. A primp here and a twirl there, and voila! A pompadourable! And all thanks
to the dingle hopper.
Give you $2 sand for it.
Scuttle, no.
I'm telling you, kid, on the open sea, you won't get any more than a few clams.
I'm not selling it, Scuttle. I'm saving it for my collection.
Well, how's about a swap? I've got something stupalicious. Museum quality, really. A banded, bulbous, snarfblat.
Wow.
Second cousin to the tuba. It plays music? Sure thing it does, kid. It ain't just blowing smoke. Why, it makes music so fantabulous. So
music. Oh my gosh, my father, he's gonna kill me. The concert.
The concert was today?
I completely forgot. Come on, Flounder. Thank you, Scuttle.
Well, if you change your mind and want to sell, call me first, you hear?
Of the deep. Today marks a special anniversary. Many years ago on this fateful day, I inherited my father's kingdom and banished the sea with Ursula forever.
Hail King Triton!
And so it's time we must celebrate our victory. In honor of this special occasion, may I introduce our master of ceremonies. So, tell us, what have you in store?
I got a special song just for the occasion, and it's gonna be performed by none other than your 7 lovely daughters. I wrote this little number for my star pupil.
And who might that be?
Your youngest, Ariel. Such a voice, that child. Notes as clear as ice, pitch as pure as water. Why, I haven't heard such a magnificent sound since, well...
Since Her Royal Highness. May she rest in peace.
You're gonna be a proud papa. You'll see. If only she'd show up for rehearsals every once in a while.
Let the merriment begin!
Oh, we are the daughters of Triton, great father who loves us and named us well.
Quata,
Trina,
Aritha,
Katina,
Anna,
and Ariel. we hope to enlighten the hearts of the merfolk with music swell, Aquata.
You might go whipping up a hurricane by mistake.
Well, look what the catfish drank.
Daddy, please forgive me. I'm so sorry.
Aaron! Young lady!
I just forgot, that's all.
As a result of your careless behavior...
Careless and reckless behavior!
The entire celebration...
ruins completely destroyed! This concert was going to be the pinnacle of my distinguished career!
Sebastian.
Now, thanks to you, I'm the laughingstock of the whole kingdom.
We gave up a date with the whale.
I don't sing backup for
Mama
anybody.
Mama would be best, but now she's gone.
Do you mind? Ariel, please. You've been given such a gift.
I know. My mother's voice.
It's a wondrous town. One that demands stewardship and care. So please, for the sake of her memory.
I will, Daddy. I promise.
It wasn't even Ariel's fault. That know-it-all seagull just kept going on and on and on.
Seagull! Seagull! You went up to the surface!
Nothing happened.
You could have been seen by one of those barbarians. One of those humans.
Daddy, they're not barbarians.
They're dangerous. Traps and harpoons. Like it or not, Ariel, you're my youngest. My baby. And so I worry about you the most.
But I'm old enough to look after myself.
As long as you live under my rules.
If you just listen to me for once.
That's the last time you're swimming up to the surface. Understood.
You're so unfair.
Heaven help me. She's headstrong, willful, stubborn as a barnacle.
Teenagers, you give them an inch, and they swim all over you.
I can govern a kingdom, but I can't control my own daughter. I was too harsh. She'll learn to fear me. She needs her mother, Sebastian. So do I.
Now, sire. It's difficult, sure. But you gotta toughen up, not melt down. For Ariel's sake. No, I'm telling you, that child needs constant supervision. Someone to watch over, keep her out of trouble.
It's not a bad idea. Someone to safeguard her every move.
Her every dog pedal.
Her every side.
Her every dive.
And you are just the crab to do it.
What?
You heard me. From now on, Ariel is your responsibility.
But sire, she's a clever mermaid. I'm just a crustacean. Surely you ought to pick someone higher up on the evolutionary scale.
Thank you.
mistress of the deep.
Beauty of the brine.
You should have seen it. All those merfolk singing Triton's praises and cursing your name.
Declaring a national holiday.
Holiday, my blowhole.
Day my brother Triton got greedy, that's all. The day he stole my half of the kingdom.
To think your very own flesh and blood.
And he double-crossed you.
His own sister.
Casting you into exile, a life of shame and unceasing solitude.
In the shadowy depths of the serpentine sea.
All right, all right! Don't blow your fuses, boys. It should have been mine. All mine. When I was a kid, a squirmy little squid, I was number 7, born of 7 little girls. 7 little pearls, pretty as could be, perfect to a T, all except for me. Ugly as a slug, hideous to hug. Daddy found me loathsome and disgusting, I could tell. They all got adored, I just got ignored. Plus to ease his guilt, a magic shell used to belong to my Papa Poseidon, full of lethal hexes and spells. My little sea snakes, the perfect gift for a spurned, dangerously unstable child.
And then your dad went and had
Triton, a male heir. As soon as he came of age, he stole everything from me. Every ocean, every lake, every pond, every puddle. So my dear, flotsam and jetsam, it's time I took revenge. Revenge on what he loves most. For now he has a child.
Sweet, but rather wild.
And she has him wrapped around her flimsy little fin. She will be our inn. She'll be what we use. Bait he can't refuse. There's no way we'll lose.
Daddy's little angel.
Daddy's little pet.
Daddy's little priceless gem.
So sassy, so smart. The key to his heart.
Ruiner as it were, it'll rip him apart.
Yes, Daddy's little princess. She's the one to get. Now just take it from a pro.
Oh, just get Daddy's little angel. Trust me, fellas, I do.
Daddy's little angel.
Yes, indeed, I do.
Daddy's little angel.
Trust me, fellas.
La 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 la
la la la la la la la la la la
untold. How many wonders can
and one cavern cold. Looking around here, you think, sure, she's got everything. I've got gadgets and gizmos aplenty. I've got who's its and what's its galore. You want thingamabobs? I've got 20. But who cares? No big deal. I want more. I want to be where the people are. I want to see, and dancing, walking around on those. What do you call them? Oh, feet. Flipping your fins, you don't get too far. You see, legs, they're required for jumping, dancing, strolling along till the, what's that word again? Street. Up where they walk, up where they run, up where they stay all day in the sun. Just you and me, and I could be part of that world. What would I give if I could live out of these waters? And what would I pay to spend a day warm on the sand? Betcha on land they'd understand. I bet they don't reprimand their daughters. Bright young women, sick of swimming, ready to stay. Why does it, what's that word, burn? When's it my turn? Wouldn't I love to explore the shore of above, out of the sea? Wish I could be part of.
Trouble in the mind?
Sebastian!
What is all this?
Just a few knickknacks I've collected, that's all.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself. If your poor father knew about this place, he'd be absolutely furious.
No, you're not going to tell him, are you? Oh, please, Sebastian, he'd never understand.
Listen to me, Ariel. For my sake, as well as your own, it's time you'd kept your mind on your music. From now on, you will have voice lessons every day, and perhaps you can take up an instrument. The harp, maybe. Why, sure. A nice harp made out of driftwood and decorated with mother of pearl. Ariel! Hello!
Sailing? It's a joke. Their crinolines get caught in the rigging, and most of them can't even swim.
Swim, sire? Is that a prerequisite?
Sure. If we go sailing, where am I going to find her, Grimsby? A girl who's as carefree and alive as the sea itself. Where?
Well, what do you know?
Scuttle, be quiet. They'll hear
I gotcha. We're being intrepidatious.
It's too much to hope for, isn't it? Somewhere out there, a girl is a match for a guy like me.
Perhaps you're not looking hard enough.
I've never seen a human this close before.
Me neither.
I thought you were an expert.
On their stuff, sure. But egads, the sight of them! Horrible! Those broad shoulders, that square jaw, and two eyeballs the same color. No variety.
I don't know. I think he's kind of handsome.
You do?
Trust me, Grimsby. When I come across a girl in my dreams, it'll hit me like lightning.
Hurricane incoming! Trent must be angry indeed!
Man the hatches and everyone below deck, and quickly!
Eric, take the wheel!
Whoa! The atmospherical's gone haywire!
Careful, Scuttle, watch out!
Ariel!
Secure the ribbon!
Oh, good heavens!
Don't worry, Grimsby. I'll get you home safely. I'll prove it to you. I'll find her, and I'll thank her for saving my life.
You'd best come with me. A night of sleep, and you'll be good as new.
Please, you have to believe me.
You've heard too many tall tales, my boy.
No, she was real.
Yes, of course she was. As real as a siren, as real as a mermaid on the rocks.
I don't know how, but I know something's
starting right now. Watch and you'll see. Someday I'll be part of your
nerve, acting like a big fish in a small pond.
Swimming upstream while everybody else is swimming down.
If you ask me, it's because she's a Pisces. No doubt about it, she's acting fishy lately.
She's dizzy and she's dreamy. Her head's up in the foam. Her eyes have gone all gleamy. It's like there's no one home. She floats away to days, moping on the coastal shell.
You ask her where she's going, she giggles like a fool.
She barely sticks a toe down and at the tidal pool. It's more than just a phase, face it, she's just not herself. A clue.
Oh wait, oh dear, good grief, it's clear she's in love, she's in love, pounding heart, ringing bells,
I think she's even wearing brand new shoes,
she's in love.
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 obvious what they must be symptoms of. She's in love, she's in love, she's in love. Yeah, yeah.
Ariel! Aw. Ariel! That sister of yours is as slippery as an eel. Where'd she swim off to now? I gotta find her before her daddy goes looking.
Good luck. She's in La La Land.
That girl has gone head over tails in love.
In love? Ariel?
Come on, Flounder. Who's the lucky merman? Well, gee, I don't know. I didn't even know it was love until, like, the second chorus.
Buddy, you know her better than anybody.
You follow her everywhere. Not anymore. Not since she started chasing after humans.
Humans? I open brain, yet I didn't just say humans.
Oh.
And this new love of hers,
don't tell me.
He's one of them?
Oh my God! A real human? The two-legged kind?
Daddy's gonna be ripped. Dating outside her species.
Thanks, Flounder. You're a regular angel fish.
Water all around you, child. And you still gotta play with fire.
Respect, sire. You've been scouring the sea for weeks. And to what end?
I vowed to find her, and I will.
I have a better idea. On the eve of your 21st birthday, we'll host a marvelous ball. We'll invite countless eligible young ladies from far and wide.
I knew it.
To sing for you.
What?
A contest. What a better way to find your mysterious voice. You'll be married by sunset on that very day, just as your father decreed.
Yes, why yes, that's how we'll find her.
Indeed we shall. You have my word.
She's out there, somewhere. I just know.
Child, there you are. A human, you fell in love with a human.
Well, you see, I didn't choose it. It just happened.
Ah, child.
I thought maybe, just maybe, you'd be happy for me, for once.
Happy? Happy, cause you're gone plumb crazy now? Child, you got to get your head out to the clouds and back into water where it belongs.
I don't belong here. As hard as I try, I just don't fit in. If only I could be up there with him, instead walking on the very same ground he is, breathing the very same air.
Down here is your home! Life down here is better than anything they got up there. The human world, it's a mess.
You're wrong, I swear.
Believe me, child, it's true. The seaweed is always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going out there, but that is a big mistake. Just look at the world around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for? Under the sea, under the sea. Darling, it's bitter, down where it's winter, take it from me. Up on the shore, they work all day, out in the sun, they slave away. While we devoting full time to floating under the sea. Down here all the fish is happy, as off through the waves they roll.
The fish on the land is happy, they stack up in the hole. For a worse fate, one day when the boss gets hungry,
guess who's gone beyond the plate? Oh. Under the sea,
under the sea,
under the sea,
under the sea.
Nobody beat us, fry us, and eat us in fricassee.
Under the sea,
we were the best.
Mockery of everything we hold dear. Where is she hiding?
If I only knew.
She keeps secrets from me, Sebastian, not from you. I'll wager you know where she is. Now take me to her.
Oh.
this with his own two hands.
Ariel! Drowning.
Who told which one of you?
I'm sorry, Ariel. I'm just a guppy. Just a lousy guppy.
You get every single solo, and it's just not fair.
Do you mind? Leave us alone. You too, Sebastian. So, did you?
Daddy, I had to save the prince.
You had to?
Without me, he would have perished.
He's a human. You're a mermaid.
I can't hate them just because they're different. Maybe you can, but it's just not in me.
Different? They catch us with their hooks. They spear us
they're
with their blades.
They're not all like that.
Have you forgotten what they did
to
your
mother? We don't know that for certain.
Can there be any doubt?
You can't prove anything.
I know it in my heart, and that's enough. Murders, all of them.
You can't blame all humans for a few wicked ones.
I won't have you build a shrine to them.
No.
Worshipping the debris that sullies our waters.
Please.
The totems of their decadence.
Please don't.
Never again, Ariel, never again!
Showing it. He can break every treasure I own, but he can't break me.
Well, you just might break his heart.
And you, some friend you are, bringing him here to my secret place?
For your own good, child. I pray you wake up from this madness, and soon you're swimming in some dangerous waters.
Poor child.
Poor sweet child.
She has a very serious problem, hasn't she?
If only
there were something
we could do.
Who are you two?
Sweet child.
Poor child.
So treasured.
So misunderstood.
Dear child.
Sad child.
Life's looking,
shall we say,
not good.
No.
Who needs woes and worries?
Who will help her get her man?
Sweet child, perhaps the sea witch can.
Can't possibly mean Aunt Ursula.
She knows your dreams.
She'll grant your prayer.
She'll cast a charm.
A tiny spell.
No
one will tell.
One will care.
It's your affair,
sweet child.
Dear child. Poor child.
Sad child.
We'll bring him to her lair right now.
Bed in half a sec, you're a prince and you are reconciled.
Together forever. Take me to her,
sweet child.
Hello? Ariel? Where'd you go? It's me, Flounder. Ursula! Ariel!
Oh, mistress of the deep. You've a visitor.
I'm not so sure.
Now, now.
shy Ariel, darling. It's me, Auntie Ursula. I shouldn't be here.
Nonsense.
We're family. Father says you're wicked and hateful.
Yes, but he says the same thing of humans, now doesn't he, Snookums? And we both know that's not true, don't we?
Well, why did he banish you?
The ocean wasn't big enough for the both of us.
And now I see he's driven you away, too. He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, Dumpling. We're so very like you and I, girls with ambition. Nothing scares a man more, does it? Now, tell dear old auntie everything.
I'm in love with a human.
Yes, this prince fellow, he's quite the catch. The answer is simple. You've got to become human yourself.
Can you help me?
Help you? My dear, sweet child, that's what I live for. To help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor souls with no one else to turn to. And I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me, well, a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways, repented, see the light, and made a switch.
True?
Yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And here lately, please don't laugh, I use it on behalf of the miserable, lonely, and depressed, pathetic, poor, unfortunate souls in pain, in need. This is one longing to be thinner, that one wants to get the girl, and do I help them? Yes, indeed. Those poor, unfortunate souls, so sad, so true. They come flocking to my cauldron, crying spells, I send them please, and I help them, yes I do. Now it's happened once or twice, someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had to rake them across the coals. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been a saint to those poor, unfortunate souls. Here's my best offer, baby Kins. I know a spell that will turn you human for 3 days. Now, it's got a procedural clause, sort of a sweet pro quo. Before the sun sets on the third day, you've got to get dear old Princey to kiss you. If you do, you'll stay human forever.
And if I don't?
Nothing drastic, darling, I'm sure. Oh, look, small print. Your soul is mine forever, and you don't have to spend eternity in my watery house, so Claire. Lawyers. I just love them. Of course, there is one more thing, my fee.
But I don't have anything.
I'm not asking for much, only your voice.
My voice?
Don't worry, I have the perfect place for it. Your grandpappy Poseidon gave his magic trident to your father, but this was his gift for one.
Your magic shell.
You've heard about it?
Father says it's the source of all your witchcraft.
Nonsense.
He says that you'd die without it.
Die? Oh, please. It's a bauble, a vessel for your voice. Trust me, darling, your vibrato, your legato, maybe your belt. They'll all be safe and sound in here.
But if I give away my voice, how will I ever be
you'll able to... You'll have your looks, your pretty face. And don't underestimate the power of body language. The men up there don't like a lot of blabber. They think a girl who gossips is a bore. Yes, on land it's much preferred for ladies not to say a word. And after all, dear, what is idle prattle for? Come on! They're not all that impressed with conversation. True gentlemen avoid it when they can. But they don't in swoon and fawn on a lady who's withdrawn. It's she who holds her tongue who gets her man. Come on, you poor unfortunate soul. Go ahead, make your choice. I'm a very busy woman and I haven't got all day. It won't cost much, just your voice. You poor unfortunate soul. It's sad, but true. you've got to pay the toll. Take a gulp and take a breath and go ahead and sign a scroll. Flock some jet some now, I've got a board. The boss is on a roll. You poor unfortunate soul.
Now look at me, you see this thing? And as for style and sapphire fair, well, I guess there reads a whole lot there. Yeah, although perhaps it makes no sense, I strut my stuff with lots of confidence. Cause though I lack an awful lot, there is one thing I got. I got positivity. I got positivity. It gives me the Sam and the Sal and the yada, waddle, waddle. That's why I walk with a wig with my waddle. Cause once you've heard that word, there ain't nothing you can do. And that's how positivity works for you.
Positivity. Why, there's no such word!
But of course there is! Right in the dictionary between pop-supple and prehysterical. Believe you me, I've seen it work miracles!
See, with the pip and the bap and a ba-ba-boo, you can flip and you flap till your wish comes true. The tip is to tap into something that you believe.
With your sing and the song and the scissor scene, there ain't nothing you can't be. You see, it's really your prerogative.
You simply can't think negative.
Walk real tall upon your own 2 feet. Sure you'll trip and make mistakes. You've got what it takes.
Do you? For a moment I mistook you for someone else. What's the matter? You're hurt? No. You need help? A bit dizzy, aren't you? I've got just the remedy. A warm bath and a hot meal. Come on now. You'll be fine. The palace isn't far.
Bravo, Ariel! Now that's what I call reeling them in.
This is gonna get me in some real hot water.
Can you believe that guy? What a crab.
Now. Nothing you can do, and that's how positivity works for you.
Child, as if the loss of your mother wasn't enough.
Mm-hmm.
The poor child washed ashore like kelp. Perhaps it was a horrible shipwreck. We'll never know the truth. She won't speak. Not a single solitary word. Do what you must to make her presentable. Brush your hair, wash your face, a proper frock.
Getting your strength back, dearie.
I can't help but wonder, what must she be thinking? I'd give a farthing or two just to hear her thoughts.
Les poissons, With a cleaver, I hack them in two. I pull out what's inside and I serve it up front. And I love little fishes, don't you? Here's something's for tempting the palate. Prepared in the classic technique. First you pound the fish flat with a mallet. Then you slash through the skin, give the belly a slice, then you're out some something. Cause that makes it taste nice. Zutalo, I have missed one. Shh. Sacre blue, what is this? How on earth could I miss such a sweet little succulent crab? Quel dommage, what a loss. You belong in the sauce with some flour, I think just a dab. Then I'll stuff you with bread. It won't hurt cause you're dead. And you'll surely be lucky you are. Cause it's gonna be hot in my big copper pot. Tout à l'eau, mon poisson. Au revoir.
Hasn't it, Prince Eric? Since we dined in the company of such loveliness.
Usually it's just me and Grim. He's got to stare across the table at my ugly mug.
The dress certainly worked its wonders. She's groomed for a groom, you might say.
Easy, old boy, easy. My, isn't that unusual? Thank you.
Don't tell me she's fond of tobacco. Aha, it's the pipe. Can't say I blame you. It's an antique meerschaum from Dusseldorf.
Sorry, old friend, but it looks like your pipe smoked too.
Very amusing, yes. She certainly knows how to make you smile. Shall we? And now,
for something truly exquisite. The creme of the creme de la creme. Oh, you may ask, but what is it? It's a teensy surprise, a delectable treat. One I'm sure you'll just love. Allez, bon appétit. But smelt, fish kebabs do not melt. If it's gilled, it's been grilled to a T. Fish lightly toasted and roasted and steamed, tossed in the blender and tenderly creamed. Dish after dish like you wish you have dreamed. And now for the grand finale, la pièce de résistance, a delicacy by golly you won't find in restaurants. A tippet du tige taste buds with a certain je ne sais quoi. Voila!
You want
first look at the two of us, eh? What a couple of misfits. You're a quiet girl in a noisy world. And I'm a prince who'd rather be a simple sailor. We're both fish out of water, you and me. What, did I say something wrong? I'm sorry. Who needs words anyway? A smouse is just as much sometimes. Nimble on your feet, aren't you? Dancing beats small talk any day. Why, sure. It's the way your feet smile or laugh. It lets you say so many things. Dancing is a language that is felt instead of heard. You can whisper, sing, or shout without so much as a word. Try it, go on, like so. Just let your emotions tell your body what to do. See how much a single gesture can reveal. And every little step, every single step, is one step closer to saying what you feel. Once the music hits you and inhibitions fall away, and you find that you're expressing things your voice daren't say, don't be afraid, let go. Soon as you surrender, what's inside will sweep on through, as the boundaries between us disappear. And every little step, every single step, is one step closer to talking loud and clear. A dance is like a conversation, except you'll never need to make a sound. And once you've begun, you speak as one, give and take, back and forth, round and round. Dancing is a language that is felt instead of heard. It says much more than a language ever could. And every little step, every single step, is one step closer. One step closer. One step closer to being understood. Myself lately. It's after midnight. I should let you get some rest. Good night.
Up, out of the frying pan and into the fire. The things I do for you, young lady. Now I know what I should do. I should march you right back home to your father.
So you can be miserable for the rest of your life. It's true. I got no backbone. All right, child. I'm in.
But we got to get that boy to kiss you before it's too late. Now a few tips from a clever crab to a little mermaid. You have to bat your eyes like this. You got to curl your lips like this. You put those two things together and tomorrow you got that boy in the palm of your hand. Now off to bed with you. Thank you.
That was too close for comfort, boys. Just one night and they're already dining together?
Then dancing cheek to cheek.
I should have known. There's only one thing more potent than my black magic.
The power of true love.
Teenage hormones! Seems a little tart. He's off to quite a start. Just one night and Princey Poo is wallowing in bliss. Think what they will do by sunset number two.
What?
Idiots! Go up and love that kiss!
Yes, your wretchedness.
In the meanwhile, her poor proud puppy, Betty's wondering where his baby's been.
Worried, sick.
So upset, not happy. Soon he'll guess, then, oh yes, all the fun'll begin. Daddy and his angel, how they're gonna hurt once our plan is in full flow. Once a kiss goes amiss, then the girl will be mine. Once she's had, then her dad will be caught on my line. Let us sail on the shell and up to heaven they'll go.
No girls ever dared to join me out here. Too afraid they'd muddy their shoes. But not you. Peaceful, isn't it? Not another living soul for miles and miles.
Nothing is happening!
They spent all morning on horseback, then a picnic, now this, and not so much as a peck on the cheek.
So, how about this weather?
This is going nowhere fast.
24 hours left. He'll be married off and poor Ariel, she'll be deep sixed.
We gotta do something, and quick.
But what?
We gotta create the right kind of mood.
Something romantical. Candlelight and shampoo.
Nonsense. Don't take all that. Everything we need, we got right here.
Percussion.
Strings. Winds and moonlight.
There you see her, sitting there across the way.
Sha-la-la.
She don't got a lot to say, but there's something about her.
About her.
And you don't know why, but you're dying to try. You wanna kiss the girl. Yeah. You know you do, but suppose she wants you to. There is one way to ask her.
Kiss the girl.
Don't take a word, not a single word. Go on and kiss the girl.
Sing with me now. Sha la 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 la. My oh my, looks like the boy too shy. Gonna kiss the girl. Sha la 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 la, ain't that sad? Ain't it a shame to bad? He gonna miss the girl.
You know, I really ought to know your name. Maybe I can guess. Alexandra. Annabelle? Beatrice.
Ariel. Her name is Ariel.
Ariel? Ariel? Hey, that's kind of pretty. Okay, Ariel.
Now's your moment, floating in a blue lagoon. Oh, you better do it soon, no time will be better. She don't say a word, and she won't say a word until you kiss the girl.
But don't be scared, you got them three big one and he's the girl. Cha-la-la-la-la-la, don't stop now, don't try to hide it. You wanna kiss the girl. Cha-la-la-la-la-la, float along and listen to the song. Kiss the girl. Cha-la-la-la-la-la, music play, do you the music sound?
You wanna kiss the girl. You gotta kiss the girl. You wanna kiss the girl. Wanna kiss the girl.
Quickly! Block that kiss!
What on earth? Arita, are you all right?
Sebastian, what was that?
Lightning?
From underwater?
Must be some kind of freak storm. I ought to head back. It's my birthday tomorrow, and we're hosting a contest. Grimsby wants me married by sunset, or else.
Most merciful King Triton, I'll pray that you keep calm.
Where is she? Where is Harry?
She'd be so angry if she knew I was here.
I entrust my youngest daughter to you. And what happens? Out of you cracked. Out of you shell.
He almost was, Your Majesty. And all for Ariel.
And you? You ought to be ashamed of yourself, too. What kind of tragedy will it take?
A tragedy involving the sea witch, to be exact.
What? Did you say?
These two eels came, and they took her straight to Ursula, and she traded her voice for a pair of legs, and if the prince doesn't kiss her by tomorrow...
She bartered away her voice for a pair of legs?
By sunset tomorrow, that child could be giving up her very soul.
Her soul?
And all to that wicked sister of yours.
It's time I settle things with her once and for all.
Before bedtime? Farewell, then. You'd best catch 40 winks. A big day tomorrow. Prince Eric must choose his bride. Mustn't look so blue. The secret to happiness, child. We mustn't wish for impossible things. Good night.
Am I not plus? I've got
That's not her voice. I'll know it the moment I hear it.
Listen to this, clear as can be. You'll know I'm it when I hit my high C. What did you think of the girl? The girl who has everything, everything, everything. I'm a world famous collaborator. My vibrato is second to none. I'm a walking display of performance. It's so clear, can't you hear?
I wish I could say yes, but she's not here.
But her father rules all Prussia. She's richer than Midas. She's one of the triplets, but they're willing to break up the set.
No, Grim.
You'll be the death of me, boy. What am I to do? The sun is nearly set. Soon, your birth will be over. You must choose someone. Perhaps if we steel ourselves. Take another listen.
Ariel!
For heaven's sake, child, you mustn't...
Shh! Be quiet and listen. Go ahead, Ariel.
Oh, child. Poor lost child. I had so hoped, dear Eric, that you might find love somewhere in this room.
Perhaps I have. I've just been too blind to see it.
But that's impossible. She didn't utter a sound.
No? Well, that's funny. Because I heard every single note, as clear as a bell. That must mean something, old boy.
Perhaps it does. Can it be? Another contestant?
That's it. That's the voice.
Oh, this is most unexpected.
Tell her that the contest is over. Tell her she's too late.
One. Such a gorgeous sunset. And on the third day, too. Time's up! You lose.
Eric!
Ariel!
I'm dragging you down, down, down into the depths where you belong.
Your daughter signed a contract.
No.
Even drew a little heart above the eye. Is it binding goodness? Yes. Unbreakable unless.
Unless.
There is a little something we could try.
Go on.
Yes. Perhaps we could arrange a sort of trade-off. Maybe swap your daughter's soul for, say, your own.
What?
Sign the scroll and set her free. Or else she comes with me to suffer through eternity alone. A mute little hatchling, drowning in her own sorrow, with no voice left to call out your name. Well,
I'm waiting.
It's not my soul you're after, it's my power.
Which would you rather be, a king of the sea or a father to his little girl?
Ariel.
Finally, the oceans belong to me! And now you are a fortunate soul. Time's up. You're through. Now the power of Poseidon has been once again made whole. All the magic of the trident and Michelle in my control. And now dark shall reign forever over ocean, sea, and shore. Now see for yourself how banishment feels. You are a fortunate soul.
Egad, look out!
She's got the shell.
My black magic now.
My voice. The spell, it's broken.
Give me back my shell.
If it breaks, you die.
You really believe that? After all the lies he told you?
Lies? What lies?
You told her the world above was hideous.
And what was it instead? Beautiful. Beautiful beyond compare.
He'd say anything to turn you against the prince and his kind. Why? He's shameless! He even say they murdered your own mother.
Wait a minute. If humans didn't kill my mother, then who did?
It was you, wasn't it? All these years, I've been blaming them, but it was you.
Who? What? Why, I put it hurt a minnow!
You liar!
No! Ursula!
Ariel!
Dad! Can you ever forgive me? Caused you such a terrible worry, only thinking about myself. Not my sisters, not you, not this place. The only place that I've ever called home.
I'm the one who's at fault, Ariel. Cursing humans for no harm.
There's been innocent people, Daddy, I've seen it.
Even when I could've, I'm proud of you. Your mother would've been too. Somehow, in the blink of an eye, when my back was turned, you grew up. You love him very much, don't you?
It's what she wants, Your Majesty. More than anything, please.
You belong to his world now.
Thank you so much.
Sunrise. We search again.
But Your Majesty, she's lost.
I won't rest until I found her.
Look, sire!
Ariel.
Eric.
It's been your voice all along, hasn't it? Who are you?
This is my father.
I'm King Triton.
Astonishing, I must say! Why?
guilty.
Your Majesty, at last, I found someone who makes me eager to seize the future and claim my birthright as king. If I slip out to sea sometimes, I don't think she'll mind, because she'll be right there next to me, keeping us both on course. With your permission, sire, I'd like to make her my wife.
My permission? Ariel can speak for herself.
Yes, Eric.
Can't be happening. No. Walk after bedtime, a bad idea.
And you must be the young man's father.
Heavens no. His Majesty's long dead. I'm his guardian, nothing more.
Well, I wager his father would be very pleased with the both of you.
Why, thank you, sir. He's my one shining achievement. A bright light in a dark world.
Well then, congratulations to us both, my friend.
And to you, yes, and to you.
Tales and superstitions, Akron.
So that's truly the king of the sea, and she's his daughter?
Does that upset you?
Goodness no, I'm just relieved she's royalty.
Just you and me.